For the latest film interviews, reviews and everything making news in pop culture, subscribe to Film Companion now. Hey guys, welcome to what promises to be a really fun but equally nostalgic episode of Spill the Tea. I'm at what they call the Little Things house, all set for the grand finale on Netflix. I'm really curious to find out what they've created inside. So I'm going to take you guys with me. And who better to show us than the lead cast, Mithila Palkar and Dhruv Sehgal. Come on. This was not staged at all.
Yeah, this was not staged. It can't be this awkwardly, naturally awkward.
Come on in. Guys, what is going on? Budget kafi tha is bar?
Budget aur mehnat achhi thi is bar.
What is going on? Tell me a little bit about what we are going to see.
In this house?
Yes.
Oh, we've just done a tour, so now we know. Okay. Yeah. This is kind of the house encapsulates the essence of what Little Things has been. So where we're standing right now is basically...
The balcony area.
Yeah, which is Dhruv's space essentially.
Yeah, a lot of plants. The bird feeder is missing, but one can obviously imagine it.
Yes.
But
yes.
It's yeah, really yeah. Lovely.
Because Kavya ne to kabhi kuch kiya nahi hai mehnat apne ghar ko maintain karne ke liye.
I didn't say that.
He didn't say it, but he wrote it.
No, blame it. I'll blame it on the other co-writers.
Exactly, said it. But anyway, yeah, so this part is Dhruv's space.
There's a lot of green. Listen, I want to get it out at the start itself. Why are you breaking so many hearts? Why have you announced season finale? Why couldn't we have just tagged along till you guys got old or something?
Hai na?
Yes.
Like after 20 years, मैं क्या सोच रहा हूँ हमारा retirement का जो वो है ना mutual funds तोड़ लेते हैं.
See, it's all coming. It's there.
It
let's
can
go.
Come for the entire life. No, but it's nice. Also, it's coming to an end in a way.
Nice for whom?
I think we
haven't used this answer.
No,
so
if we have to be honest, I think we both of us. I mean, I'm taking my liberty to speak on his behalf too, but we also have very mixed feelings about the fact that the show is ending, because it's literally his baby and mine too, because we've literally grown up with the show. And like my sister recently actually said, how are you feeling? Because it's sort of an end of an era.
Stop by the tapri. Oh, yes. Because why not?
You must, but there is no chai, so sorry.
No chai.
Spill the tea.
You should have gotten it.
Yeah.
But yeah, my sister actually recently said to me, how are you feeling about it? Because it's like an end of an era. And I didn't even think of it that way. But
yeah,
I think we should just end it on a good note. And
But I kind of feel like your sister, because exactly what you said, I feel like I kind of grew up with the show.
Yeah.
Really, I did. So I want to know how the two of you are dealing with letting go of Dhruv and Kavya. That's not a small deal.
It's not, but for me, I don't think it's hitting me right now. It'll probably when the show will release, and the day I won't get a single message about the show, I'll be like, oh, it's officially over. Nobody has written that this helped me through my divorce or this helped me when I was dating this guy.
Although I don't think that will end.
The show's there,
and it's there for everybody to consume as much and as many times as they want.
But you know, there's always that day. The day before where you get like 90 messages, and the day after you're like, oh, not a single one today. So that immediacy, it'll come to us.
I know what
it is. Yeah.
You know, when it goes on Netflix, you know that many people are watching it. I binge watched it. I had the privilege to before doing this interview. It was a day binge for me.
Yeah.
But it's also like, tomorrow bacha graduate ho raha hai now. It's time to like,
I
as parents, so. Like, you know, now it's okay.
I don't know if I'm ready to let go of Kavya. I don't think there is any other character that so far I've played with as much ease. I think if you wake us up in the middle of the night and say, hey, we're doing a fifth season, Dhruv and I will be like, okay, chalo kar lete. Like, it's that for us. But similarly, I don't think it's hitting me just yet. I think there will be a time when it'll hit me and then I'll write to you.
You know, first day of season 3, there was a scene where both of us are sitting and having a meal. We were having poha.
Huh.
And I had shot before that, a day before that, and it was first of Mithila.
Huh.
And roll sound action cut. and she said a line, and the moment director said cut, Mithila is like, it can't be this easy, yaar. This is so easy.
Sure, I don't remember this.
I was going to ask you just about that, but I will now pause at these flowers and try and discover the romantic in you. Two beautiful girls, what flowers do you pick?
They're all made of plastic, but...
Nahi
yaar. Arey,
sach mein?
Haan, nahi wo peeche wale plastic ke the. Peeche wale plastic ke the. I like the white small ones.
Baby's breath.
Baby's breath.
That's what they're called?
Yeah.
Lovely yaar.
Even
what a nice name.
Recently
free mein milte. When you buy a bouquet na.
Haan, to site mein mil jate hain, but lovely name for
them. It's like kadi patta.
Kadi patta, that's
sorry,
a nice
word. I love kadi patta. No, but I do want to ask you guys about that. I've scientifically tried to understand what it is about Dhruv and Kavya's chemistry. I know I tried to ask you this the last time we spoke and you didn't have a real answer. It's not about the physicality because it's quite limited. It's not about like the grand gestures either. Does it piss you off when you're working with say another co-star and wo aata hi nahi hai itni like organically? Does that happen?
No answer, because I don't work with anyone else as an actor.
He signed a contract that he's exclusively only going to work.
He's like such a faithful husband, you know. Okay, you know, I yeah.
Husband.
I think that's like in.
Yeah,
I.
By the way, congratulations.
I think we are married to the show.
Husband, yes.
Thank you.
Yes. Bolo.
Dhruv is married, guys. Not to me.
Sexier than ever.
Do you get that a lot?
Yes, of course I get that a lot. I think I'm pretty sure even if we tell people that he's married, people will still ask us if we're together. Like, I don't think it'll register really. But to answer your question, I don't even remember this episode that happened, but like what you just said. But yeah, it isn't as easy to just glide into a character and come out of it, because I think even as a writer, he'd given me the liberty to do whatever I wanted to with it. Of course, the essence of Kavya is all him, but I had the liberty of saying things the way I wanted to. I had the liberty of giving her my voice.
And did she become you a little bit?
I think so. I think in the third season for sure.
Yeah, he felt kind of schizophrenic at one point because he's like, "Ye Dhruv vats hai ki Sehgal hai, pata nahi."
Nee, mere liye in the third season it happened, because I think I have grown up with her in that sense, so that's what makes it easy, because it's literally like I've grown up as Mithila, I've grown up as an actor, and I've grown up as the character. So it's a lot of things, and the growth has happened simultaneously. So I think she's very close to me.
I want to talk a little bit about that actually. I also love how organically this your answers are feeding into my questions. Talk to me a little bit about how you grew up with the show. Like, where were you in 2016 in life and where are we now?
Good question, man. I remember I was telling my mother today, it was a Wednesday, the bosses at the company, Pocket Aces, guys, they asked me, "Ke yaar, aisa sab kuch likh de, two people in a room or in a house, limited setup." I'm like, okay, cool. So Thursday I wrote it, or Thursday I started writing it, Saturday I sent it, Sunday was a holiday, I didn't do anything. Monday they're like, "This is really good, we should make this." And I remember I was living with a friend of mine who also edited the promos of this show. And I was single then I dated someone, and then I became single again, then I dated someone again, and then I got married. And it's not just me, you know, who's gone through change. Then I was looking at the change that has happened in my brother's life, in my parents' life, you know, they retired. So yeah, it genuinely feels like the world's moved ahead, even though you feel like it's not, but it actually has, which is kind of nice also.
Yeah. You?
Exactly what he said, and like parallel to my life. And I think even as a show, and as in terms of the making of the show, in terms of what we wanted to tell through the show, the stories that we told through like Dhruv and Kavya also kind of became more personal in a sense. Like in the third season, when it became about, oh, parents are growing old, and yes, that was actually happening, yes, at home. And I was like, oh my God, this is just, it's getting too close to home now. So I think those changes definitely happened. Personal life, of course, I mean, as actor,
आज बोल दे.
As an actor,
बोल ही दे.
आज बोल दे ना यार.
Spill the tea.
Yeah, come on, यार.
क्या बोलना? अच्छा वैसे. Oh my God! It didn't even. Oh God! It didn't even. I am not married to Dhruv. That's what's happened
in
four years.
Oh man! Now something was the
other thing. This interview is clear. On the thumbnail level,
just to make it clear,
I am not married to Dhruv.
But I'm still. I'm still.
Single.
Single.
single is the way to be. And I've got access to your bedroom. How often do I say that to an actor? So let's go upstairs. Yes. This is my favorite kind of shoot. I'm sorry that you are a glamorous.
Dressed up.
You look great.
Nothing like Kavya. Yeah, so for a change, I try to, like, for promotions, I try to glam up.
Yeah, yeah, as you must. You. But listen, when we spoke in 2018, you guys told me that for both your families, being an actor still meant Bollywood. Mm-hmm. But like this many years later and a Netflix show later and everything else that you've done, do they give you more bhav now?
Yeah. More bhav as in that question doesn't arise as much. Achha. They don't ask you ke, but wo wali film kab karega, you know, that wo idea of cinema. Yeah. So now they know the kind of, at least the person that I am, and you know, so like it's nice what he's doing.
Yeah.
Because they also watch other shows besides Little Things now, right? So my father will scam dekha tune and I'll be like, abhi dekhna hai. You
know? But has fandom changed for you? You were very awkward about it when we spoke last. Like his mother would force him to take pictures with fans.
I don't think it's changed.
It's not changed.
Knowing Dhruv for these many years, I don't think.
No, now I'm better at it. You know, I enjoy it actually. You know, it's a part of me. Especially when I'm traveling out of Bombay and Delhi. And then suddenly in a random part of the country, you're like, are you that boy? I'm like, yes, I'm very much that boy. Genuinely, you feel people smile at you, you know, it's a nice feeling.
Yeah, it's a nice.
And because it's not that crazy that you're not, you know, compromising on your privacy or anything like that, it's really nice.
Yeah. Well, you're easily one of the internet's favorite boyfriends, I'd say.
Oh, yes.
Yeah?
Yes. Created too many ideals now, it's a problem.
Yeah. Problem for me also.
But Dhruv, you didn't write this season.
No.
Which is a first for you. But was that in any way easier for you to separate Dhruv Vats from Dhruv Sehgal? Like,
maybe, yeah. I mean, I guess. I mean, the kind of it was easy. I mean, the reason why I didn't write is because I was sort of kind of. I felt I was not able to. I would not have been able to give my best because the characters sort of stopped surprising me. You know, it didn't feel organic. It felt like I'm going to force myself. And I just thought that if I can't do a good job or an honest job, good, bad is all relative, then I should not try and do it. But actually, now I understood the craft of acting more also, because suddenly I'm given lines that I've not written, you know, and I have to make them my own.
Yeah. Welcome to her world.
Yeah, welcome to her. And I used to tell, I'm like, dude, what a difficult job, you know, but because we know the characters well, we would just, you know, change a little bit, you know, and not change the essence of it.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's damn difficult being an actor. Like, I still tell her, I don't know how you do this.
But like, to be fair, the writer in him was still alive through the
on
show.
Set?
Yeah.
Improv?
Not exactly improv, but yeah, there were times when Dhruv's like put his, there is this thing he does where he like puts his specs here. And then he'll squint his eyes and go into his writer mode and then just like...
You're going to miss all this, na?
Of course.
All of it, man. It's genuinely a lot of fun shooting with this team. You know?
Yeah. Also, we've literally, every single one of us has grown with the show. Like it's like Ruchir, or who's one of our directors, and Anirudh Patankar, who is our DOP. And all of like the core or our producers, of course, from Pocket Aces. All the core of the show is still that.
Yeah.
And we all still, like, I'm pretty sure, like, Aruchir's definitely not going to miss Dhruv and I's banters over. No, ye aise bolenge hi nahi Dhruv aur Kavya. Ye aise ho hi nahi sakta. No, ye kya hai? Ye aise kyun hai? But...
Or him saying, kitna baat karte ho yaar?
Tum dono?
Yeah.
Nahi, tumko nahi lagta hai show mein abba.
You should speak to the people who, you know, help us do our dubbings in English. They're like, arre bas, ab lunch ke baad. Aur nahi sun
sakta. I am actually going to miss that too.
Yeah, same.
I'm going to miss Fazal sir from Sound and Vision actually.
So
I
much.
Do want to
shout
mention.
Out to Fazal sir.
Definitely, because I think he made that process of dubbing the entire show in English also so much fun for us. So yeah, it's been a journey. I think I'm definitely going to miss it. And I think as we come closer to the date, I'm definitely going to have one breakdown session also. Right now, it's still like 10 days away. So
you're holding it in for now.
Or no, I mean, I don't know. I'm able to hold it in for now, I think. As it comes closer and when it actually is like, when I watch the last episode, I guess, for me, it'll be like, okay, this is done.
But you know, there are still some days, like my parents are here. So my wife is also, you know, first time. And I'm like, would it be nice to at least do one episode post-marriage? Because what about that part of their life? You know, suddenly you feel close to these fictional beings.
Yes, but also, I feel very close to them.
Yeah. And then I'm like, what if I have to go somewhere and, you know, the three of them have to stay, then what about, so, I mean, your mind.
There are possibilities, there are endless.
No. Who knows? But
I mean, as a couple, it's like it's life.
It's life. Like,
there's a lot that can happen with them. But I guess at the same time, I think it's also, I don't know, I'm trying to see the positives of it, and I think it's okay to hold them back also, because it can fray and go all over the places as well. Not that I don't trust him.
Or
as
it
a
may
writer,
become
but
artificial,
just,
you know,
I'm
then that's
saying,
the worst thing.
He's like, sorry. I think he's ruined most of our lives, because as single people, we are like, achha, ye abhi thoda difficult ho gaya hai to find this kind of a relationship.
Yeah. Or he's also kind of helped us actually focus on the little things.
Yeah.
Well, I wish that would have been. That's the case with, but credit to everyone, I guess, for that.
How did you kind of keep the focus on the little things when the budgets got bigger and the expectations got bigger?
You just have to be true to the characters, you know. They are the first and the last checkpoint. That you have to be.
Kavya ye nahi karegi.
Yeah, Kavya or Dhruv, you know, just you have to embrace what the core idea of the show is, which is the little nuances of life. And it's not just about love, you know, like there's a scene where the father and son, they bond over a bird feeder and what birds actually come in their house in Delhi and in Bombay. But you know, it's just seeing life for the little joys that it can give you. So that was the idea, you know, and hopefully it has sort of come across in the last season also. Good journey. Yeah. Really, really nice journey.
What's the most overwhelming thing a fan of the show has told you over the past 4 years? Something that stayed with you? Because you do this to touch lives, right?
A lot of divorce stories.
Really?
Yeah. And you know, it's only now, since the trailer came out, that I've started screenshotting messages.
I, in fact, shared one with Dhruv recently from a YouTube comment that when you guys started the show, I was dating. Then the next season, we were in a long distance. Then the next season, we got married. And this season, we are going through a divorce. So, it's essentially, everybody's gone on a journey with Dhruv and Kavya. And that's just so wholesome to just know.
Yeah. And whenever, at least, I get a message on my Facebook, not on Instagram, by someone who's above the age of 60, it really touches me, you know.
Because
they message that, you know, I live alone. My kid is here and I'm a widower and I watch this show and it's really helped me. I genuinely believe in the goodness of the show, you know, because we know the kind of logistics that go into making a show. You kind of feel detached after a point, but like the good vibes, they kind of connect. And sometimes we get messages from Turkey a lot, Brazil a lot, you know, countries with similar cultural roots, and it's really nice here.
There's a wall that's quite fascinating there. I want to see whether they bring any memories for you guys.
There's a BTS story to every image.
Yeah. Talk to me about what's happening.
Oh, this is 36 takes.
This is,
36 takes.
From season 1. 36 takes. What?
Yeah. That was a bad day. And
I'm sorry.
I don't remember the exact.
I remember it very well because my friends Viraj and even now Pat is like, 36, mat kar dena. And I'm like, nahi, bhai, 36 nahi hone wala.
And then it became a running joke. Like in the next season, Dhruv got so on point with his lines that like the minute I gave like 13 takes, and in these 13 takes, other things have also gone wrong. Aur wo saying ek beech mein kabhi mera fumble ho jata
light ka idhar
to wo he used to gloat acha double digit take and all that. So that became a running joke until like I think
abhi. You remember?
That's the first scene that we ever shot of the show, the Valone one.
Last scene of the show.
First season.
It was shot
at Valone, yeah.
It was the first thing we shot, yes. For once we traveled.
So evidently grown up, na? I mean, look at you guys.
Yeah.
Kya?
मतलब इसके बाल अब थोड़े ज्यादा कंट्रोल में आ गए मिथिला के.
कर्लिंग प्रोडक्ट्स.
या स्नेहा एंड आई शेयर अ
कर्ली गर्ल जर्नी
गर्ल मेथड. दीचा तो
कंट्रोल में आ गए. गुड ऑब्जर्वेशन. ओके टेल मी फाइनली व्हाट आर द लिटिल थिंग्स दैट यू आर गोइंग टू मिस इन अ बिग बिग वे. I feel like a therapy session, huh, guys? Like,
yeah. Also, the bed is kind of
conducive to conversation.
Wow, everything. Just Dhruv scribbling about having to act.
36 takes.
And generally, our collective script. I'm sure Dhruchir and Pat are definitely going to miss that. Us scribbling. But yeah, just generally spending time with, like, I think a good part of the year we spend together over the last 5-6 years, because some part of it goes for him went in the writing and then in the making and then in the post and so I think the fourth season we shot over 2-3 months.
Yeah, 2-3 months.
It just feels a little overwhelming to just like hear. Yeah I can imagine.
Yeah, it's I mean the time that goes in shooting, the time that goes in writing, because to write a show like this also with the other co-writers, you know, is you talk about your most screwed up memory of your childhood, you talk about the happiest thing that's happened,
intimate private things,
exactly, you know, it so just the kind of intimacy that happens through the journey of the show is what I'll miss, because you know now I go on set, you know, it's an ad shoot, it's a promo shoot, it's a chota sa shoot, then you feel like, you know, the girl will come, she'll do your hair and makeup, the artist would come, and then, but there's no connection. But with this show, we have this connection with the team, you know, which is why, you know, our characters that, you know, they say the summer vacations of a life is coming to an end, but I genuinely feel the summer vacations of at least this part of my professional life, because after this, you know, I feel everything will become a little more serious, you know, and then another phase will come when you can have fun again. But I think now it's just that fun ke chalo aaj dost logo ke sath shooting karenge. Yeah, I'm gonna miss that.
It makes me really sad that I don't have anything to like look forward to now, since I already binged the show, damn it.
Watch it again.
But I'm gonna wrap by taking you guys to one last spot, and I've got some Nerf guns. Since you've come such a long way, and after all that emotional spiel, we're going to get to how well do you know each other, but with a Nerf gun. And when you guys watch the season on Netflix, you'll know why the Nerf gun reference. But I'm going to ask you about him, and if you get it wrong, he gets to fire.
Oh my gosh.
Pressure.
Okay, I'm very stressed.
Okay. Sir.
Arey, thank you. It's loaded also.
It's loaded.
My gosh, and I'm going to like blow
cute
bubbles.
Nerf gun.
Cute.
Okay, fine.
How old is Dhruv Sehgal? Exact.
32.
Yeah, correct answer. So, now?
Later.
Bubbles!
No, I'm 31. No, wait, 90.
That's my answer here. I couldn't doubt you, man.
Yeah, sorry, I'm 31.
What's wrong with you, Dhruv?
I'm 31.
Fire!
So. Oh, that was fun. Can I get some more bullets?
एक तो खुद का ही एज भूल गया ना.
Yeah, amazing.
So I get points for it.
लोग यंग होना चाहते हैं, मैंने हाँ बोल दिया था. हाँ बोल दिया.
I was like, oh, he must have grown up. Wikipedia is not updated. मैंने रहने दिया. Okay.
Yo.
That's okay. It's okay. I'll blow up.
Yeah, ठीक है.
It's I'm that's kind. Perfect. When is Mithila's birthday?
Oh, Jan.
Convenient.
Between 10 to 15. Hey, that's good enough, yaar. है ना, correct?
13
What does Dhruv have a tattoo of? Nikala to nahi na? Hai na?
Koi pata hai, acha surgeon main nikal deta hu abhi iske baad hi.
I don't know what it is, but it's a script. It's a Chinese script.
Yeah.
What does it say? Hope.
Love, dreams, prosper. No, it just says music. in Mandarin. Oh. This is fun though. Yaar ek baar tu bhi maan le, I'll feel more balanced.
Yeah. Kya himsa chal raha hai idhar? Chalo, okay. I need to ask you.
We clearly don't know anything.
Yeah, exactly.
What is going on? How many views does the Cup song have on her YouTube?
It's Pernay Malik.
I can give him options if you want.
How would I know this?
ये तो मुझे भी नहीं पता.
Okay. 2 million, 6 million or 12 million? You're going to get hit anyway. If you go too low, she's going to be like, what are you?
No, 6.
Correct. 6.9 now. Well done.
सब प्यार से बोला. If you go too low, तो obviously ना बीच माला ही तुम दोगे answer. ये स्नेहा is partial. If you guys have not noticed.
Fine. How many followers does Dhruv have on his Instagram?
I don't know. I really don't know. So forget. I really don't know. You can hit. It's okay. I don't think he knows how many I have. It's okay.
Yeah.
We are really hopeless at this game.
You know, I started answering in my head ki iske kitne hain, mujhe to dekha hi nahi.
Haan. Hai. Theek hai.
Yeah,
hai. It's okay, it's okay. 50k I want to say, but...
No, no. It's around 240, 250. Yes.
Hey, yaar. Star hai.
नहीं वो है लेकिन वो ऐसे ऐसे हाइडिंग में चला जाता है ना तो फिर वो पता नहीं चलता उसका मुझे भी सडनली ही इज लाइक
लाइक सम इन्फ्लुएंसर कैंपेन्स ऑन योर पेज
बिकॉज़ आई जेन्युइनली वुड वांट टू बिलीव ही इज अ लाइक ही इज अ 50k नोकिया होल्डर पर्सन बिकॉज़ ही इज द ध्रुव दैट आई नो
आई डिलीट माय इंस्टाग्राम आफ्टर द फर्स्ट सीजन केम
आउट सी
हु डज दैट
ध्रुव
इज गेटिंग टू मच
दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग
व्हेन वाज द फर्स्ट episode of Little Things season 1 released.
She would know this.
No.
No?
I want to say August, September.
I feel like it's, it 2016. Was May or June, July.
No, so you're totally off.
I think it's August, September. 2016.
August?
It's October 25th, 2016.
Chalo, at least I'm not like January.
Yeah.
No idea.
Time for all of us to go back home and binge.
Yeah, and revise all this.
Yes. Guys, I think this is a very bad segment because it proves how Dhruv and I just don't care about each other.
Sneha will be like, ke, yeah, this isko main edit kar de, log sochenge ki chemistry fake hai.
We love each other, guys. We love and respect each other. It's just that these conversations about how many followers do you have and never really came up.
All our conversations like, so what time will you have lunch today?
What will you have for lunch? Dhruv aur mere text messages on set to ye hua. Acha tu set pe jo khana hai wo khane wali hai? Nahi main yahan se order kar raha hu. Tujhe chahiye tu bol dena production. Ye hamare conversation.
Or we knock on each other's vanity. Tuck tuck tuck. Biryani aa gayi hai. Shall I send it? You wanna like?
It's a special kind of friendship, guys. And
it is.
Thank you really for little things more than anything else and for this conversation.
Thank you.
I hate to imagine that I won't be doing one of these because I've literally interviewed you guys for every season of the show. But thank you for the memories.
Thank you for being
thank
a part
you.
Of it. Yeah. Hi guys!
This is probably the last time you're seeing Dhruv and I as we promote little things on Spill the Tea. I'm sure Sneha will call us over anyway.
So the new section hai yaar wo sari baatein yeah. But thank you for making us a part of your show
my journey I grew up with you guys so thank you
so much for having us so if you like this video be sure to give it to hit the like button share it subscribe comment
and
subscribe to Film Companion right. I just said it in all the order was all over the place but you get
by now you get it
but thanks team.